Hello friends, today we'll learn about the working of Moti Autocline filter. This is the traditional or old version of Moti filter which is fitted in SEMT Pilstick engine. This one is the new version of Autocline filter by Alpha Level company. Working of both filter is similar. Let us quickly go through the basic components and opening of the filter. This is the main inlet of unfiltered oil to the filter. This is strainer. A distributor assembly. Moti filter have two chambers, namely full flow chamber and the other one which is known as diversion chamber. This is the drain cock to drain out the sediments or sludge. A hydraulic motor. Full flow filtering element. Opening from filter to the engine sump. And this opening feeds filter oil to the engine parts. The filter consists of two types of filtration elements. One is known as diversion filtering element. The other one is called as full flow filtering element. Both are different in construction as you may see in the picture. Now let's go through the working of filtering elements. In the middle there is a distributor shown here, and from the passage filtered oil enters into the filtering element. This arrow shows the filtered oil going to the engine. From the middle of distributor, backflushed oil which cleans the filtering element comes out and goes into the diversion chamber. This animation shows you the working of the distributor. This is how the filtration takes place in the autocline filter. Now let's see the internal components of the filter. In the housing, there is an outer cover. The outer cover consists of a sleeve which carries both type of filtering element. On the upper side, diversion element. And on the lower side, full flow filtering element. Inside the sleeve, a oil distributor is fitted. Now let us see the working of Moti filter. Filtering part have two phases, phase 1 and phase 2. So let's begin with the phase 1. Unfiltered oil enters the full flow chamber of the filter and flows into the chamber, which is the space between the distributor and the inner perimeter of the sleeve, where filtering elements are fitted. From chamber, the oil is distributed into and through the filtering columns formed by the filter elements. The solid particles are trapped. The filtered oil is fed into chamber, where it flows to the engine through the filter outlet. Approximate 200 liter per hour of filtered oil flows from the chamber to the hydraulic motor through a feed pipe. This feed pipe drives the hydraulic motor. While the full flow filtration takes place in all columns except one, solids are removed in one column by backflushing using part of the filtered oil from the chamber. The backflushing oil with its solid passes through the channel in the distributor to the divergent chamber. The backflushing oil passes from the divergent chamber through the divergent filtering elements to the passage in the distributor. Filtered oil is taken back through the passage in the distributor via outlet. In the first phase, no backflushing is performed in the divergent chamber. Now phase 2. In this phase, the distributor has rotated one step compared with the phase 1, as you may see in the animation. This is the rotation. Part of the filtered oil in the chamber can now pass through the channel in the distributor and through the divergent filter elements from inside to outside, removing the trapped particles from the outer side of the elements. The particles trapped by the filtering elements can thus settle to the bottom of the divergent chamber. The solids filtered out in the divergent chamber are then discharged from the system by the periodic drain by the drain cock. Thanks for watching this video. Please comment below in the comment box for suggestions. Thank you.